अभी रोते हैं, अभी अगर कोई रोए उनको कोई समझाने वाले नहीं चाहिए, लेकिन समझाएगा तो
जो समझ तो कंसोल दैट पर्सन
एक दूसरे भाव को समझते हैं। अगर कोई रोए अगर
If someone can understand, so someone is there of your like-minded person and who consoles you, then your distress is mitigated. But Krishna is weeping in Mathura, calling out, Ha Radha, Ha Lalita, Ha Vishakha, and he's weeping and weeping on, and there is no one to console him. If one weeps too much, then he becomes mad. So if you tell the distress of your heart to someone, then that distress is reduced. But there is no one here to understand the love he has for the gopis in Mathura. So Krishna thought that if I send some person from Mathura to Braj to understand the Braja love, then that person can get training from the gopis and then return to Mathura and be able to console me. If someone can take association of Radharani and her sakis and then learn in that university of Radharani and obtaining a degree from that university of love, if someone can return to Mathura, then that person may be competent to console me. An example is given that there is a water. If there is very deep water, there is a reservoir which is very deep and there are many wells, eddy currents like wells, then what will happen? Then due to wells in the water, then that person will, if he is not expert swimmer, he may sink in that reservoir of water. So Krishna is thinking that this love is like an ocean and the love of the gopis is like an ocean. If I send someone incompetent person, then that person will drown in that ocean of love. So he sent some of the topmost devotee Uddhav, he selected as a person to get training how to swim in that ocean of love of the gopis. But Krishna also knew that even Uddhav wouldn't be able to swim in that ocean of love. He can only ascertain the depth of that ocean. He can try to fathom the immensity and the depth of that ocean, but he wouldn't be able to swim in that ocean. The complete goodness is Uddhav. Who is Uddhav? He is the embodiment of complete goodness, Shuddha Sattva. He is Sri Krishna's minister. He is also Sri Krishna's best friend. And he is the disciple of Brihaspati. Because Uddhav, when he joined the school in this material world, on the earth, in Dwarka, he asked questions to many teachers and none of the teachers could answer his queries. So finally all the teachers told him, you better go to the heaven and take education from Brihaspati because we can't satisfy your queries. So that person, Uddhav, so intelligent, and he has learned from the best of the teachers, Brihaspati, he came to Braj and he saw the condition of Braj. Bhagavan sent Uddhav. Bhagavan Shri Krishna told Uddhav in Dwarka that you can experience only one manifestation of me, a plenary portion here in Dwarka. But if you want to experience my complete manifestation, my Swayam Roop, then you have to go to Braj. As soon as Uddhav came to Braj, he saw the Braj was as before. It was green, birds were chirping, cows were grazing, The cows were drinking from the udders of their mothers. Bulls were chasing the cows, and there was absolutely no mood of separation. And all the cowherd girls, they were carrying the milk products on their head. They're going to fetch water. Everything was going as before. But when Uddhav offered obeisances to that Braj, then everything disappeared, and then he saw the mood of separation manifest there. Uddhav went to Nandagaon. When he went to Nandagaon, he tried to pacify Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda. Although he tried to pacify Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda, their separation from Krishna rather increased when Uddhav told them that Krishna is Bhagavan. And also Uddhav became wonderstruck to see the mood of immense separation which gopis were experiencing. Especially Radharani's mood completely stunned him. The separation which Radharani experiences in separation of Krishna, the distress she experiences, is bitter than billions and billions of oceans of the deadly poison called Kalkut. So, and Rupa Goswami has explained in Bhagavatam that in Brahmargit, song of Bumblebee, that how Radharani was chastising Krishna, sometimes glorifying Krishna, is called Chitra Jalpa, Sanjalpa, Ujjalpa, Prajalpa. So like this, there are 10 types of Chitra Jalpa are described elaborately in this Brahmargit. So the deep mood which is in the heart of Radharani, even Brahma and Shiva want to obtain the moods of the gopis. Even Radharani, she wants to obtain the same good fortune as Radharani, but they cannot obtain. Finally, Uddhav offered the most famous prayer, Asam Aho Charna Renu Jisham Aham Syam. Uddhav aspired for a particle of the dust of the lotus feet of the gopis, especially of the Radharani. So he wanted to become blade of grass or herb or shrub. He says, I repeatedly offer obeisances to the lotus feet of the gopis. Sri Uddhav is asking for food dust, a particle of food dust. But whose particle is asking? Radharani's only. So all the blades of grass which are surrounding this Uddhav Kunda are manifestations of Uddhav from different days of Brahma. In every day of Brahma, when Krishna enacts his pastime, Uddhav comes and becomes a blade of grass here. Only by the mercy of Giriraj. So Uddhav, he became a blade of grass and did austerities here to obtain the foot dust of Radharani. When Krishna, when he disappeared from this world, all the 16,107 queens of Krishna were feeling immense separation from Krishna, except for one queen. Her name was Kalindi. Kalindi was not feeling any separation. Then all the queens of Krishna, they inquired, hey Kalindi, are you not feeling separation from your husband, Krishna, from our husband? So then Kalindi told that these are two aspects of Sri Krishna's pastimes. There is called Vyavaharik Leela, that Krishna's Bhoma Leela, that earthly pastimes may become manifest and sometimes become unmanifest. But Krishna's Golok pastimes or Dwarka pastimes in the spiritual sky are eternal. Then Kalindi told that one time Krishna, he sent Uddhav to Braj and he consoled Nanda Maharaj, Yashoda and the gopis.
So we should contact Uddhav. So then Uddhav Maharaj, Uddhav Brahma.
So Uddhav came here. So Uddhav came here and Parikshit Maharaj all came and they did Bhagavat Katha. And when Uddhav did Kirtan and he recited Bhagavat Katha, then that time Bhagavan Shri Krishna appeared there along with all the gopis, along with Radharani, and then very wonderful Bhagavat Katha was done. And Arjun was playing the drum. So one day of Brahma, Bhagavan Shri Krishna comes here once. So when Krishna disappeared from this world, he told me one secret. I am going in one form. Then Krishna told, Uddhav told that Krishna has told me a secret. Although I am going to Golok Vrindavan, I am keeping my selfsame manifestation, my literary incarnation, Bhagavat here. So if anyone will study Bhagavatam, then Bhagavan himself will manifest. So Uddhav stayed here for 1 month. And staying here, Uddhav recited Bhagavatam here for 1 month. So when Uddhav recited Bhagavatam for 1 month, then Krishna manifested here. Then all were doing the kirtan. Uddhav, some was playing kartal, some was playing mridangam. And all the 16,108 queens of Krishna had darshan of gopis, Radharana. So this is the place where Uddhav recited Bhagavatam and Bhagavan Shri Krishna manifested. So we pray that Uddhav is a Prematur Bhakta. If we can obtain. So we pray that we also should obtain that mood of the gopis which Mahaprabhu had come to give. Namo namo.